Hello everyone, myself Ashok Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this class, we are going to discuss about the analysis of superelevation on road. Learning outcomes of the today's class. At the end of the session, students will be able to understand the function of superelevation, analyze the superelevation on curves, and calculate the superelevation for different design speeds. We know that when vehicle traverses on a horizontal curve, the centrifugal force acts horizontally outwards through the CG, and this centrifugal force depends upon the speed of the vehicle and radius of the curve. And it is given by W V square upon GR, RP by W equals to V square upon GR, where V is the speed of the vehicle in meter per second, G is the acceleration due to gravity, and R is the radius of the curve in meter. We know that when centrifugal force acts on the horizontal curve, we got two effects of centrifugal force. One, because of the centrifugal force, it tendency to overturn the vehicle outwards about the outer wheels. And another effect of the centrifugal force, tendency to skid the vehicle laterally outwards. Now let us see these two effects one by one. First effect is overturning effect. Now due to the centrifugal force, the vehicle may overturn on the outer side of the road or outer side of the wheel B. Let H be the height from the road surface to the CG of the vehicle, and B be the width of the wheelbase of the vehicle. Now we'll take the overturning moment towards the outer wheel B, that is P into H is the centrifugal force acting on the vehicle. To resist this centrifugal force, we got the restoring moment due to the weight of the vehicle, that is W into B by 2. For equilibrium condition, now we'll equate this centrifugal force to the restoring moment, that is PH equal to WB upon 2. Or the centrifugal force P by W equal to B by 2H. It means that when P by W or centrifugal force, centrifugal ratio attains the value of B by 2H, there is a chances of vehicle may overturn on the outer side of the road. Or when P by W exceeds the value of B by 2H, there is a chances of vehicle may overturn on the outer side. Now this is transverse skidding effect. Now, when the centrifugal force exceeds the value of this lateral coefficient of friction, there is a chances of the vehicle may lateral skid on the outer side. To resist this centrifugal force, we got the friction force that is developed between the bottom surface of wheel and the pavement surface, that is given by F into Ra and F into Rb, where F is coefficient of friction, Ra is the vertical normal reaction in the wheel A and wheel B. Here the pressure intensity over in the inner side of the wheel is lesser compared to the outer side. Here, because the pressure intensity is more, because centrifugal force is acting on the outer side. So hence the pressure on the outer wheel will be more compared to the inner wheel. Again, for equilibrium condition, we'll equate centrifugal force equal to the Fa plus Fb, and we know that Fa equal to the F into Ra and Fb equal to the F into Rb, where Ra and Rb are the vertical reactions. And we know that Ra plus Rb is your weight of the vehicle, that is weight of the vehicle acting through the CC downward. So that is if Ra plus Rb equal to the W. Again, P by W equal to the F. It means that when centrifugal ratio attains the value of lateral coefficient of friction, there is a chances of the vehicle may skid on the laterally outside. Hence, it reveals that we should keep the P by W ratio lesser than B by 2H and lesser than your lateral coefficient of friction. Hence, without the superelevation, depending upon entirely on lateral coefficient of friction is not safe, because there is a chances of the vehicle speed may increase in the curves, or the radius may decrease at that point. So entirely depending upon the lateral coefficient of friction is not safe. Now you pause the video and try to answer this question. When F is less than B by 2H, now you select vehicle would go for skid or vehicle will overturn. Other side, when B by 2H is lower than F, you select whether vehicle will go for skid or vehicle will overturn. The correct answers are, when F is less than B by 2H, vehicle would go for skid, because where F is less than B by 2H means it is less than your P by W ratio, that is centrifugal ratio. There the vehicle would go for skid, not for overturn. Other side, when B by 2H is lower than F means, again here is also it is lesser than P by W ratio. Hence, here is also the vehicle will go for overturn, not for skid. To overcome this effect of overturning and lateral skidding, we have to raise this outer edge of the pavement with respect to the inner edge. This raising of outer edge with respect to the inner edge is called a superelevation, or giving a transverse inclination to the pavement surface is known as a superelevation or cant. It is expressed by E in percentage or 1 in N. And it is given by rate of superelevation, that is E equal to the NL upon ML, or that is equal to the tan theta. This theta inclination with the horizontal is very small. And the value of the tan theta seldom exceeds the value of 0.07. And practically, the value of tan theta is equal to the sine theta. Hence, the sine theta is equal to the E upon B. So you want to calculate what is the raising of the pavement with respect to the width of the pavement. So you can multiply E equal to B into E. B is your width of the pavement and E is your rate of superelevation. Now we will derive the equation for calculating the superelevation on curve. Before we derive the equation, let us understand what are the forces acting on the vehicle when vehicle is negotiating on a horizontal curve. The first force, the centrifugal force acting outward horizontally, that is given by W square upon GR, or centrifugal ratio P by W equal to V square upon GR. And self-weight of the vehicle, W acting downward through the CG, that is by W. Now the friction force FA and FB acting at the pavement surface and wheel surface. And RA and RB are the vertical reactions. Now we'll resolve these forces with respect to the inclined surface. Now with respect to the inclined surface, the component of the centrifugal force is P cos theta. And to resist this P cos theta, we got W sin theta plus FA plus FB. Now P cos theta equal to W sin theta plus FA plus FB. We know that FA equal to F into RA and FB equal to F into RB, where small f is the coefficient of lateral friction. Now RA is resisting W cos theta and RB is resisting P sin theta. Now we will replace this RA and RB by W cos theta and RB by P sin theta. Now equation P cos theta minus F sin theta equal to W sin theta plus FW cos theta. Now we will divide both sides by W cos theta. The equation becomes P by W 1 minus F tan theta. Here sin by cos is tan, and W sin by cos is tan here, and W cos theta will get cancelled. The equation is tan theta plus F. The centrifugal ratio equal to P by W equal to tan theta plus F and 1 minus F tan theta. Now we will put the F value as 0.15, that is maximum coefficient of lateral friction, and tan theta, the theta value is 0.07, that is maximum superelevation is 0.07. So 1 minus 0.15 into tan 0.07, approximately it becomes a value of 0.99, almost it is 1. So 1 minus F tan theta becomes a value of 1. Now the remaining P by W equal to tan theta plus F. Now we know that P by W equal to V square upon GR, and tan theta is equal to the, that is rate of superelevation is E, and put that the P by W as V square upon GR and tan theta is E. So E plus F equal to V square upon GR, where V is in meter per second. So sometimes we need to convert the equation into V in kmph. So put this, the convert this V into meter per second. To convert that, multiply by 1000 and divide by 60 into 60, that is converting from second to minute and minute into hours. So equation will 0.278, and put the G value as 9.8, so 9.8 upon 0.278 square. So approximately it becomes 127. The final equation when V is in kmph equal to E plus F equal to V square upon 127R, where V is in kmph. The references used for preparing this presentation are shown here. Thank you.